Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, you can do better than that. Amen. Amen. Truly, God, you is worthy to be praised. Amen. We're going to call the service order. Amen. And I ask everyone, if you will stand on your feet at this time for a moment of consecration. Amen. Let's bow our heads at this time. Amen. While you're standing, we're going to be reading our theme song, which is taken from Matthew, the 5th chapter, verses 44 through 45. It says, "But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that you may be the children of your Father which is in heaven." Our request scripture is taken from Philippians, the 4th chapter, verses 4 through 6. Says, "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be made known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." And our permanent prayer request that Bishop Baker, Bishop Morgan, and the church family request that we rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing that the church stay on one accord, that the house of prayer continue to be established in peace, that God's will be done in each individual request and all nations of the world. And at this time, we're going to have Minister Lindsay and Minister Thomas come to give us all scripture and prayer. Amen?
Amen. This prayer means so much to me. I don't know even what it means to you, but it means a whole lot to me. And just hear what you're saying to God. So let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
Comes from Galatians 4 and 4. Amen. Thank God for Jesus. But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his Son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. And because ye are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son unto your heart, crying, Abba, Father. Amen.
Amen? Amen. Now, come on, somebody bless the Lord real good. Amen. Come on, give him a praise. Amen. Come on, open up your mouth. Yeah. except me. And I found out that he said that God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So my question to you is right now, what did you bring that God will accept from you this morning? That he will come down and inhabit. The Bible said he will inhabit.
praise you for what you're going to do. There's none like you, none before you, and none after you. You are God and God alone. Thank you for these, your people, God, as we come now to exalt your name, lift your name above every other name, and at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. We confess now that you are Lord of lords, King of kings. You're the great I am. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Greeting to all of us that are here listening by our conference call, by Facebook Live, by every means that available to us to exalt the name of Jesus. You that are joining us for the very first time on conference call, on Facebook Live, and here in this sanctuary with God peoples, if you're with us for the very first time, then let's give God peoples conference call, Facebook Live, in this sanctuary, one of the best. God bless you. And those that are continuously, and we continue to solicit that you pray for me, Sister Morgan, and our family, our daughters, grandchildren, and those that are connected to us. We pray that if you pray for us, we pray for you.
Amen.
And prayers has no distance. We thank God for the service at this time. We thank God for those that work behind the scenes that are making things comfortable for us, that we may come and fellowship. Thank God that we're wearing the mask.
Amen.
The face behind the mask, God knows just who we are.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He knows front, back, left, and right.
Amen.
He knows his peoples.
Yes.
All over the earth, God got good peoples.
Yes.
All over the earth.
Yes.
I was sharing with the ministers a few services ago. We was ministering. And that's why we're the love people. Sister Morgan was stressing this morning from the scripture. We're the love people. God people are to love people. Amen. When you love people, you understand why God made us who he made us. Every peoples on this earth are made from the dust of the dirt. And they are scientists says, and biblically says, we're made from the dust of the earth, and there are five major dust that the dirt produce: red, white, black, yellow, brown, and if I left one, it's five. Amen. And God made all of us, amen, for his glory.
Amen.
My God, hallelujah. We should not have problem loving who God loves. I was listening to the choir singing this morning, The Rock, and I thought about Peter. They were singing that song, and Jesus spoke to his disciples and wanted to know from them, who folks saying I am? What the people saying about me? Lord, hallelujah. I would ask you, even when people say good things about the Lord, don't get caught up in people. Glory, because the same people that say good things about the Lord, they'll let the devil speak through them. So Jesus asked the question, who do men say that I am? Amen. And they responded, amen, by the voice of Peter. Some say you're Elijah. Some say you're one of the major prophets. Amen. And Jesus said, well, good, but who do you say I am?
Yes, sir.
You know, you walk with me, you've seen me work miracles, you've seen me raise the dead, and you got to remember and be reminded that these were not grown old men. Glory be to God. Sister Morgan was talking about this morning, that it's a wonderful thing to get old. Amen. That means you're no longer a child. You no longer act like children. You're at the stage where Paul said, when I became a man, I put away childish things. But you got to be reminded that these was boys. These was teenagers. then, follow me. Peter was a little older because he was an older man, probably in his 20s, amen. And we know he was older because he was a fisherman, amen. And not only was he old, he was married, amen. Don't you remember when Jesus went down and healed his mother-in-law? Glory, he was of age to be married, amen. But they was following him as young men, 16, 17 years old maybe. I'm not a scholar, but I know what the scripture says. Amen. We look at them as grown men. Glory, we got to begin now to minister to our young peoples and minister to our youth and pray that God will save our youth at an early age. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Early age that they would want to, as the Bible said, give their life to the Lord in their youth.
Yes.
Glory be to God. We cannot afford to let our youth grow up in a time like we in as we combat sin. Amen. We combat fornication. Amen. We cannot allow this next generation of young people to grow up with 5 and 6 children and ain't married.
Amen.
Don't have a wife. Amen. Grew up in a time where they don't know how to love people.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Don't know how to love one another and got to deal with a racist society. We cannot afford to let this next generation grow up to follow Christ. Amen. And not know that he's Lord of Lords. And who do you say that I am? And they said, you. Peter spoke out, being a little of the older one. It's time for the older one to speak out and let the children keep silent. I don't care what your age is, you ought to be children in the Lord. If you're 50 years old, you ought to still be as a little child, children of the Lord. Say amen. Amen. But it's time now for the older one to speak out that has some experience, not only with things of the earth, but have some experience and know that if you set yourself in a situation under the master, God will speak to you.
Amen.
But don't get caught up because he speaks to you and you speak in tongues. Same devil week while you speaking in tongues. I got to hold my peace now, but he's not going to speak in tongues all day.
Amen.
Glory be to God. He's not going to preach all day.
Amen.
He's not going to sing all day. He's not going to shout all day. I got time to wait.
Amen.
Glory be to God. And then I'll buff them. Say amen. Glory be to God. Say, you're the son of the living God. My God. And Jesus said, Peter, you're a man of age, but my father revealed that to you. I keep reminding us this is a revealed ministry. Our bishop, the founder of this ministry, did not go to theology school and tell man, and man told him what to preach. Glory be to God. And ain't no need to get upset with me because you rely more on the letter than you do the spirit. Glory be. I'm not knocking neither one, but you're going to need the spirit. Glory, the letter kills. My God, it'll kill the person that's talking in the letter. They get up and lift Jesus' name up higher. My God, and still commit sin when they come down. But the letter with the spirit, it make alive. Glory be to God. And if you got life in you, talking about the life of Christ, amen. Glory be to God. You don't like sin, amen. He said, you're the son of the living God, amen. Glory. I don't have a Facebook message. I don't have a conference call. I have a Jesus message. My God. And I've had people to tell me, amen, stay with your text, Bishop, amen. Pastor, stay with your text. I do stay with my text when I'm moved by the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We need men now and preachers now like of old, my God, that will move and preach when the Holy Ghost said preach.
Amen.
Say what the Holy Ghost said say. And the Bible back you up. Amen. I'm going to give a text and a scripture in a few minutes, but you'll find me from Genesis to Revelation.
Amen.
Even talking about heaven and eternity.
Amen.
This world is not my home.
Amen.
I'm not preaching to stay here. I'm preaching to get out. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I want to help somebody along the way. You're the son of the living God. And flesh and blood didn't reveal that to you. Glory be to God. For my Father which is in heaven. And for the truth's sake, I'm going to build my church up on the rock. When we be built up on the word, glory be to Scripture. Hallelujah. My God, the wind may blow, thunder may roll. Hallelujah. But come what may, you can stand still in the Word of God.
Amen.
And stand as sure. Say amen. Amen. And we're going to encourage you in just a few minutes to keep praying for the Fellowship of Pastors and Churches. We do have members that we fellowship with. We don't worship these flags. These flags is a reminder that God was honorable to men, the founder, and kept his word. Our founder used to tell us that prayer has no distance. My God, it'll go all over the world. Glory be to God. And as prayer went all over the world from our founder, God revealed to me, glory be to God, that it would be a ministry as I became pastor in 1985, that it would reach national and international and local worldwide ministry. Glory be to God. I don't care how many people doubted it happened. When God gives you something, God speaks a revelation to you, a prophetic word in you, and it come out, and you speak it for the Lord. It's got to happen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And God has spoken a prophetic word to the people now, that any man come to me.
Yes.
Glory be to God. He will in no wise cast them away. That's a prophetic word from heaven.
Amen.
We are not good enough and saved enough and sanctified enough to tell who can't come to God.
Amen.
And like just because you and I come to him, can't nobody else come. His arm is still open.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. To receive anybody.
Yes.
My God. Somebody shout anybody for our Facebook
yes.
listeners. Shout anybody.
Yes.
Paul reminded us that since he's talking about anybody, don't you forget, you once was anybody.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Hallelujah. You once was far away from him.
Yes.
Glory be to God. But you made your way to him. Glory be to God. Don't act like he done went into hibernation and turned the ministry over to somebody else. Don't act like God is quiet and giving you the voice, but he's still speaking.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. He's still echoing a voice saying, come unto me.
Yeah.
All you that are heavy laden, he will give us rest. Hallelujah. Not rest from your everyday job. Some of you need some rest from worrying all night long last night. Some of you need some rest from crying and begging God to deliver your son or daughter off dope. Some of you need some rest. Glory, from crying all night long over the ambulance siren. What is that, my child? Some of you need some rest. Your son or daughter's incarceration. You ain't seen them in years and been presented a life sentence. But God can save behind closed doors. God can save behind prison bars. But he never stopped preaching. So God can raise up preachers behind prison bars. Hallelujah. They'll preach the jailer saved. They'll preach the jailer happy. They'll get the warden saved. Hallelujah. And God will give them favor. Don't count people out because they're down. Hallelujah. Not this ministry. Glory be to God. We look down on no man except to give him a helping hand. We look down on no family without telling them God is love. Father, not only do we tell them God is love, we show them love because love is what love does. How can you go to a hungry man and tell him God will feed him and you got two fish in your pocket? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. How can you go to a hungry person and tell him God is able when he done brought you from a mighty long way? Hallelujah. God is good. Amen. Glory be to God. If it ever been a time, we need to pray for our Fellowship of Pastors and Churches. Hallelujah. Name by name. Pray for our Bishop David Lewis. God have allowed me to be the father in the faith of these pastors and bishops. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I remember when our oldest daughter, baby, was murdered by a young man. Glory be to God. And that, it broke our heart. It broke my heart with the firstborn. Glory be to God. And slain by a young man. Hallelujah. In the wrong place at the wrong time. Trying to break up an argument between somebody's family. Glory be to God. Pull a gun and shot. It doesn't matter whether it was accidental delivery. She's dead. Glory. She was murdered. Glory be to God. But to have the grace of God in us, my God, to stand before my family and weep and cry, and after the weeping and crying, tell them, God said we must forgive. There's no one. She's teaching and preaching like she taught this morning. Just because I'm the pastor, glory be to God, and a man of God, give me no right to hate nobody. I got to do it the way God said to it. And I'm glad that I did. If you do it now, you may hurt and grieve while you've done it, but later on, you'll be glad you did it. My God, I had to forgive. He forgave the very person that killed our daughter, amen, and stood before the court, my God, and had mercy on them and asked the court to have mercy. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And let the court decide, let the law decide what to do. But we'd already made our decision. We forgave them. Glory, you can't wish somebody bad when you say you done forgave them. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And we forgave him, my God. And so this is what God people is expected to do. Amen. Live like Christ. Love like Christ. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, we ask you to continue to pray for the listeners. And Bishop David Lewis, there in Trinidad and Tobago, my God, I recall when I mentioned this name because God connected me in the spirit in a prophetic word. I always have been admired and fascinated with airplanes. Amen. I'm a collector of planes. My God, I got little planes in the house and been given little plane to put puzzle together, stiff plane. And I look at it sometime when I look in the cabinet. Amen. Just look at it. And I made a vow, Uncle Bob, Brother Robert, and I wasn't fearful of flying, but I knew I wasn't going to fly unless God said do it. But when you do what God said do, he casts out all fear. Hallelujah. And 5 years, my God, before we went to Trinidad, my God, I began to tell the church that whenever God said go to international and fulfill the commission, the call that he's given me, how can you have an international ministry and afraid to go there? So how can God give you something to do and you're afraid to do it? And let me share this with you because we're preaching good right now. When I told some young preachers some time ago, a young man asked me, how will he know that God has called him to preach or to do whatever God called you to do? I said, you'll do it, enjoy it, and don't nobody have to pay you to do it. Too many preachers want fame and popularity, amen, want to be exalted and want to be rewarded from man what they do for God. God will reward you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we encourage us to do the good pleasure of the Lord. And so I said, I'm not going to fly. I know it's coming a time when we're going to have to fly. Amen. And when that time comes, I'll be ready. My God. And it came ready for me to take this ministry to Trinidad and Tobago. Amen. And my wife and the ministering team that went with me, glory be to God. And we set flight from Atlanta to Miami, my God. And from Miami to Atlanta, the weather was storming. We had to go already at 32,000 feet and had to go up several more in a holding pattern. Like the plane was just sitting there. I'm just as comfortable as I can be. Glory be to God. No fear. Glory be to God. Then the pilot come over the air and said, well, we're going to have to go in because we're running low in fuel. I said, Lord, land us safely. Glory be to God. I'm encouraging you, no matter what your flight you have taken, don't let fear take over you. Some of you done took a flight in your marriage. Some of you done took a flight and your children is causing a weather storm. But I would encourage you to stay calm. midst of the storm. Hallelujah. My God. And like the plane was just sitting there. My God. No fear. Glory be to God. And then the pilot said, we got to go in. We're running out of fuel. My God. And as we come down, my God, and began to get in the atmosphere, amen, the plane just started rocking and reeling. And then he saw the runway. My God. And got on down to the runway and bumped it and landed safely. My God. And we stayed over. My God. And got the next flight on to Trinidad and Tobago. And oh, my God, we preached 5 services. Glory be to God. My God. 3 services and 1 service. A morning service, a midday service, and an evening service. And then ate dinner and went to Tobago and preached a service there. Come back Monday night and preach another service, and was sick on my way back home. Glory be to God. And I said, God, the same God that enabled me to preach is the same God going to deliver me from this sinus and allergy congestion. Amen. Glory be to God. But the closer you get home, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Sometimes the more the enemy attacks you, we're getting closer to home, church. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You don't have to say it yourself. And so we encourage us that we pray for our fellow yokemen in the Lord and pray for this wonderful congregation of people that God has entrusted me with. You don't belong to me. Glory be to God. I remember when I was almost asking the Lord for something for me to sound good. Amen. And I heard other pastors and other represented in the ministry, and they would visit, and guests would ask several of them to stand up, and they would ask their people, I want my people who are with me to stand. Sounded good, my God. And I mean, you know, some things sound good, but it ain't good for you.
Amen.
And this is my choir, and these are my members that come with me. And so I tried that one service. I was guest speaker and a service, and I said, I want my choir to stand, and my people that are with me. And they stood, and everybody clapped and had a good time. But later on that week, and the Lord spoke to me and said, who died? I said, you did, Jesus. And my God, and who do people belong to? I said, you. He said, well, they ain't yours. I mean, he know how to use English, but he knew how to speak Ebonic. He said, they ain't yours. My God. And I said, thank you, Lord. And you ain't never heard me say no more. Amen. After about 25 or 30 years, you're God's people. He allowed me to be assigned over you. Glory. To bring him glory. To warn you. To cry loud and spare not. Lift up my voice like a trumpet. You don't like me on Facebook, you don't have to tune in. But even when you don't like me, you still find yourself tuning in. Say amen, because I'm telling you the truth. Without compromising, without trying to be cute and popular. Glory be to God. And I was sharing that with somebody once, and they said, well, you do all of these good things. What's in it for you? Amen. What's in it for you? Is anything in it for you? I said, sure it is. Eternal life. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You can make it. I'm ministering to God's people. I know you. My God, after 38 years, I ought to know you. My God, in the Lord, I know you from front to back. Amen. If I see you one time as a new member, I see you again. I may not remember your name, but I remember the face. Glory be to God. And whether I see you or not, I am to live right because you remember me. And you'll ask the question, that's it. If I'm acting all rambunctious in the marketplace and cutting up and carrying on and acting less than who I say I am right now, and you say, is that the same man that I heard in the pulpit, my God, telling us to live right, and he over there smoking a cigarette and walking out of liquor store with a neck? Yeah. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. My God. And now you don't have to walk in the liquor store now. You can order it. My God, say amen. I don't know what we've done behind closed doors, but God does. to be seen here among you now. And you can't see me after the benediction, but God does.
Amen.
And not only will you see me behind closed doors in front of your face, whenever you see me, you'll know me by the fruit.
Amen.
Say amen. You can't see my smile with the mask on, but you ought to see my joy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. My God. And let me share with you, and as I proceed on in the next few minutes, before sin, that was God. Before COVID, that was God.
Amen.
Come on, before adultery, that was God. Before fornication, that was God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. God ain't afraid to catch COVID.
No.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
God is not afraid of cancer. God not afraid of anything or anybody. Say amen. Glory be to God. He's God Almighty. Glory. He understands what it means to live sin-free. And he understands when men say, don't you think God didn't warn Satan, Lucifer, when he was exalted? Don't you think God didn't see him talking to the choir? Amen. Trying to con out people on his side. Don't you think God didn't say, watch yourself, Lucifer. You're getting yourself off what you're supposed to do. You're getting yourself off your mission. My God, you see how the angels bow before me. Glory be to God. You see it. Sometimes you preachers, you got to be careful how the people seem like they clap their hand more for the bishop. And they're supposed to. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
How they clap their hand more for the mother. And they're supposed to. The Bible says, honor those.
Yes, sir.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And lift them up. Esteem them highly for their work's sake.
Amen.
My God, if for nothing else, you ought to esteem me for my work's sake.
Amen.
So you know my work as a bishop. Nobody can stand up here, male or female, and say, I pinch you on the hip.
Amen.
Ain't no woman in this man after 39 years can say, I touch you on the semen. Glory be to God. I don't care who did, I didn't. You and I lied to you. You can't do it. I'm not boasting in me. I'm boasting in the Holy Ghost. Glory be to God. Now, don't think some ain't tried to come on to me. I said, but I didn't come on to them. Glory be to God. Don't think when I tell you, husband, listen to your wife. Don't you think that you got it all together? I've had Mother Morgan to tell me several times in my young ministry, young passion and preaching. She just said, baby, watch yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Glory be to God. What you mean, girl? What you mean? Now, don't you call her girl. That's my girl. Raise hand, my girl. My God. The singers, I can't think of their name. I think it's Temptation. My girl. My girl. Talking about my girl. Not your girl. My girl. So there you call her your girl. That's your mother, the church.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. There you call me homeboy.
Amen.
Glory, I'm your bishop.
Amen.
Glory be to God. As another word, I don't mean this disrespectfully, but I have to warn you. There's another word taking over the church from Hollywood. You guys. I'm not none of you guys. I'm your bishop.
Amen.
Glory be to God. I am your leader. Hallelujah. Don't call me you guys. Hallelujah. I know if you get mad, then you need to change. Say amen. You shouldn't be calling nobody you guys. That's a stimulus that's coming into the house of prayer from the world. That ain't in the Bible. Glory be to God. We so easily get caught up with Hollywood. My God, hallelujah. My God, hallelujah. I'm your bishop, my God. We are the saints of the Most High. Honor one another as saints, my God. And if you can't honor them as saints, they're not a saint. Just say, I greet you, ain't. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You ain't no saint if you ain't a saint. Hallelujah. Now, I didn't say you wasn't saved. Many people are saved, but they ain't sanctified yet. To be saved is to believe in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. But to be sanctified is to be set apart for the master use. When he want to use your hand, they go up. You don't need musician and you do well, amen, but it'll come in more of a time that when you're playing and singing, that's your praise time. You be careful. Honor your leader, amen. Know when to hit that keyboard. My God, hallelujah. Because people need to hear now.
Amen.
I done seen the dancing. I done seen the hand clapping. But the devil ain't scared of our dance. He's not afraid of our prophecy. He's not afraid of our preaching. Only thing the devil give respect to is the name of Jesus. And if you haven't been given authority to use his name, hallelujah, you get no respect from the devil. But God give us the Holy Ghost, and then he give us authority. In other words, he makes us power of attorney. Glory be to God. You know, when someone make you power of attorney, you have the right by the law and by the bank to sign check as long as they got money in the bank. Glory, but you can't use it for your personal reason. Glory be to God. And God give us the power of attorney to use his name, but not for your personal use to be famous. Don't use his name to be popular. Don't use his name to get rich in money. Don't use his name, glory be to God, to brag and boast. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. If he had a wife, she would be a liar. If he had sons and daughters, they would be liars. Everybody connected to the devil is liars. And they are the father of the liars. Amen. Don't get mad with me. Glory be to God. You ought to thank God. We just went past Brother Lindsay and Mr. Hezekiah and Mr. Dale, Dan Lewis, and Deacon McCary and a few others. Brother Robert and Brother Clark and several others that have been in the military. Brother Goldman, you, Bill, you military people, say amen.
Amen.
They honored a few days ago, honoring those that served, even died in the military fighting for America and their country. You mean I can't die for the saints? Glory be to God. When you lie on me, you're killing me. When you false accuse me, you're killing me. When you misuse me, you're killing me. When you fight against me, you're killing me. When you walk in disobedience, you're killing me. So I'm willing to be honored by God, dying for you daily. Glory be to God. Whether you honor me or not, God honors me. Glory be to God. The devil is a liar. We can live holy. You don't need men counselors to tell you how to love your wife and how to honor your wife and how to be submissive. You vowed that when you got married. For better or for worse. Come on, he was looking good then. Come on, she was looking good. You had your eyes on honeymoon. New member, first time, don't let me scare y'all here. I'm preaching good. Hallelujah. You saw, and my daughter there, you saw it with the boots on and saw it with the dress and the hat on you. Oh, man, you done had so many, now you want her. Say amen. Glory be to God. But when you said, for better or for worse, you wasn't quoting what I said. You were talking to God. You were telling God, for better or for worse. Glory be to God. You married him for the worse because you know most of us didn't have nothing no way. Glory. Didn't even have a place to stay. My God. Hallelujah. Barely had a job. Oh, I ain't talking about now. I'm talking about then. Some of y'all come along with me then. Glory, you didn't have nothing to offer them but the vows, and you couldn't keep them. Glory be to God, honey. But God hold you accountable. I don't care what you say. I'm closing. I'll preach this another time, but I can't hear what society say. I didn't think I'd live to see two men kissing one another. Glory, just fight me if you want to. When you fight me, you ain't fighting me, you're fighting God. I didn't write these words, but God did. I never thought I'd see two women kissing one another. I never thought I'd see two women celebrating their anniversary on Facebook Live. The devil is a lie. It ain't gonna happen under my watch, and I say amen to it. I don't care who don't go with me. I'm willing to die for the gospel. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Some of you, soft-hearted preachers, amen, won't even stand up and denounce sin. Glory be. Anything you go along with, amen. The devil ain't studying what you say. Anything you scared to denounce and call it sin, the devil ain't studying about your preaching. Anything you can't call sin and tell people that's wrong, he ain't studying about your exalted. Anything you can't say that's wrong when it's wrong, God ain't studying about that. The devil ain't either. Hallelujah. Strength in the hands of evil do. You can't make people do it, but you can't say that's wrong. I got 5 daughters and 4 of them end up in divorce. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But I told them it's wrong. Amen. And they married again. Glory be to God. And they didn't marry in adultery. Because what God forgive, he forgive. If you got on your third husband now, your third marriage, just ask God to forgive you for the other two. Glory, and he will. Now, why can't we do what I'm saying and say amen? You praise God with the woman at the well with 5 husbands. And all I'm at 3. I ain't at but 3. Say, and you're sitting there like I shouldn't be saying this. But Jesus gave the woman with 5 husbands. Glory be to God. Didn't stone her to death. Hallelujah. He didn't stone that prostitute. My God, and they're sleeping with men. When they brought her to Jesus, said, you know that law, glory. What you going to do? We caught in the very act. My God, I don't know what he wrote on the ground. And ain't been trying to search Google, nor the Bible, nor theology to find out. So you ain't going to know. He didn't want us to know what he wrote. He wanted us to know what he wrote on our heart. Still trying to figure out what he wrote on the ground and can't even read what he wrote on your heart. I'm almost through. Hallelujah. I apologize to you if you were waiting on a fancy text and a fancy message and for me to go in a way to yeah. I'm preaching truth to you. You be lost, you're going to be lost because you reject the truth. You fought against your leader. Hallelujah. It's a dangerous thing to plot against your leader. Glory. I appreciate these sons in the ministry and daughters in the ministry, but don't let that David's son, what's his name? You know that, huh? Apollon. Don't let no Apollon spirit get in you. Glory be to God. Apollon couldn't wait for David to die. Glory, God extend years when you want me to die. Come on, say amen. God extend my years when you expect I'm getting too old. God extend my health. My God, I'm moving better than some of you 40 year olds. Hallelujah. Come on now, glory be to God. I move when the anointing ain't on me. Sister Morgan told me yesterday, he said, don't nothing bother the bishop. Amen. He just move and move. Yeah, it's there. Hallelujah. But God is stronger. Amen. Don't worry about me because my knee is bad and I kind of walk bow-legged. It is the Lord who's keeping me going. Don't worry about my gray hair. That's a sign of knowledge and wisdom. Hallelujah. I ain't been to shave it off and I ain't been to die. Hallelujah. Don't let no Apollon spirit rise up in you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. My God, Apollon killed his own father. One of them dead, say amen. And mess around and I don't know what the movies say. The movies say he's riding a horse and his hair got caught in the thick. And I don't know it, but I know David's servant killed him. Come on. I got some servant would destroy it. Demons for me. I'm talking about the angels of hosts. There's some servant assigned to me that you can't see. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory. I said there's some servants in the spirit realm will turn the poison arrow another way before he hits me. They'll turn that lie another way before he hits me. Glory be to God. Servant put him to death. Amen. Servant supposed to protect their leader. Servant, earthly and spiritually, supposed to uplift their leader. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You're supposed to serve the one that God has given you to serve. Hallelujah. Don't let nobody call you not to serve faithful. My God, hallelujah. Men will call you a wimp, brothers, when you are faithful to your leader. My God, and you serve him faithful. My God, you serve the bishop faithfully. You pray for your bishop and stop anybody else from saying things about your bishop. Whoa, wait a minute now. Who you think I am? Do you think I am going to sit in and let you degrade my bishop and go along with you? Not the devil, not his angels, not the imps in hell. You are a liar. If you think I'm going to do that, you think I'm going to put up with it. That's what you supposed to say, Mr. Lindsay, Hezekiah, Mr. Lewis, and all the preachers and the deacons and the saints. That's what you supposed to say. Everybody going against your leader, you may say, you may have to say, well, I don't think that's right, but I ain't going to let you degrade him. I will find out for him myself. Did he say what you say he said? Glory, because a lie changes the further they go. Come on, say, the truth changes the further it goes. My God, that's why you have to, the Bible says you got a dream, tell a dream. You dare tell some dream you dream, brothers. Say amen, your wife will kill you. Say amen. You laying over the bed and looking on to my honey, I had a dream. And she said, what is it, baby? And thinking you're a man of God and you're going to dream. Baby, I thought I was in the bed with David. Why, you better watch yourself. She's not going to say hallelujah. Glory be to God. You got to be careful. Say amen. And you're supposed to uphold your leader. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You're supposed to lift him up that God will exalt you in due time. Some of us can't wait for due season. Glory be to God. Some of us get so close that God, you've been so faithful that God said himself, my God, he thinks, and before he tell the angel, before he tells Jesus, he said, I'm thinking about rewarding them, exalting them, if they could just repent. My God, if they just stand for somebody. Look, it's a dangerous thing, especially to the ministers, male and female. I ain't got no problem with God choosing women to preach. I just got a problem with God choose women and men to preach and we live different. There ain't no double life for women as a preacher and a double standard for men. All the preachers' shoes will be shone with the preparation of the gospel. And Paul said, the gospel that I preach to you, I live by. Amen. It's amazing that you enjoy me talking about my girl and you're talking about problem that have hit me from the enemy, but ain't nothing ever happened to y'all. Come on, say amen. Devil ain't never hit your marriage. If it's to tell it. And Sister Morgan said, you're telling somebody. Somebody know when you hate me. I ain't talking about you and the devil. You done told somebody, I just don't like. Bishop getting beside himself. Amen. He getting old. Amen. Glory be to God. I mean, I've been here about almost 30 minutes. And I ain't acting like no old preacher. You may be acting like an old receiver. Glory. I'm acting as young as Mr. Lewis when he was up here, when he was telling y'all. Glory be to God. He was on up about 5 minutes. I've been up 30. And I'm still going. And you going to say I'm getting old? And you still sitting there. Some of your hand ain't went up yet. Hallelujah. Hold on, son. You can dance. I tell you got to watch this music. Amen. Glory be to God. The way I'm preaching that, some of y'all done took off and run for the Lord. Amen. Some of y'all done stood up and said, Lord, help me. Yeah. Some of y'all done stood up and said, God, forgive me. Yeah. See, the gospel won't move you, but music will move you. All right. My God. James Brown will move you. Yeah. Please, don't go. Hallelujah. My God, hallelujah. My God. When we get to where it takes the world, something from the world to move our flesh, glory be to God. When the Spirit of the Lord is being preached that don't cater to your flesh, your spirit man hands ought to go up without me asking for it. Your hallelujah ought to come out of your mouth without me saying, everybody get a Lord. Hallelujah. It ought to be a spirit we'll provide for you. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Preaching good, hallelujah. They ain't even, haven't even preached yet.
Yes.
Glory be to God, hallelujah. We need to know who we're serving.
Yes.
But most of all, we need to know who we are.
Yes.
My God, many people know who you are by name,
amen,
by your professional, by your job,
yes,
hallelujah, by your talent. But we need to know who we are.
Yes.
We belong to the Lord.
Yes.
We can't act any kind of way. We can't do any kind. We're supposed to do everything excellently.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Our common fashion ought to be a holiness.
Yes.
We're not supposed to be talking like P. Daddy. We're not supposed to be joking like, what's the one with play with Eddie Murphy and put him in that piano? Huh? David Chappelle. The little short guy about tall as me, what's his name?
Kevin Hart.
Kevin Hart, say amen. Glory be to God. When these people, what's the other one got hit on the bus and almost died?
Tracy Morgan.
He got my last name and he don't send me nothing. Glory be to God. Don't send me no tithe for the ministry. Hallelujah. My grandson ain't as bad as he used to be, but he was an Auburn diehard. My God, when Auburn is winning, boy, he get all excited. And when Auburn is losing, he taps stuff. He done overcome. Oh, my God, he has overcome. Much prayer he has overcome. Much counseling, son, it ain't that serious. Amen. And I'm an Alabama fan. So Auburn and Alabama is in Alabama. Amen. And they ain't my team. And somebody asked me one time, who your team? And one sent me some ties. Help spread the gospel. Say amen. I ain't caught up in them. Hallelujah. It's amazing how the devil will make you sleepy when you start praying or reading the scripture. But we go overtime 4 quarters. Never not. Hallelujah. Eat 2 baskets of chicken wings. I'm being a little procedural, a little method right now. Glory be to God. But I'm being factual. Glory be to God. Somebody's guilty. Hallelujah. My God. 2 baskets of chicken wings. Glory be to God. And don't fuss who cook them. You don't know nothing about the cook at puppet. Put a spit in the grease. The season hot enough. You don't know what's going on in these restaurants. Did they drop your food on the floor? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. My God. Appreciate those that work in restaurant business. Glory be to God. You make sure if I come in the establishment where you work at, you make sure you have a relationship with the cook and let them know there's a special order here. Glory be to God. Don't tell them I'm your bishop, but they may not like preachers. Amen. They may be an atheist. Don't bother them. Just say, this order's for a special customer. Glory be to God. And you kind of go back and forth while they're cooking it. You got the right in the kitchen. Hallelujah. We're supposed to watch out for one another. You ain't supposed to wish something bad happened to me. I'm your leader.
Amen.
Glory be to God. And I close with this. I shared the other day. It's a wonderful thing that only God can raise up and choose leaders. Amen. Hear me good. Only God can raise up and choose leaders. Only God can choose individuals to be spokesperson for a leader. Moses had to go back down in Egypt. Tell Pharaoh to let his peoples go. I don't think his stutter was as bad as he didn't want to go because he know what they would do to you in Egypt. He barely got out of Egypt alive. And then, God, here you want me to go back and tell the king, let your people go? My God, I stutter. He came up with an excuse. I stutter. Glory be to God. You know, it's amazing when we want God to send us to some glamorous place.
All right.
Hallelujah. But the spotlight is on us. We go quickly. But when he sent us, glory, in a hostile situation, speak this same Jesus that we spoke in a glamorous position.
Amen.
We come up with excuses. Glory be to God. And Moses said, I stutter. And God said, okay, I'll take care of that. You move all excuses. Won't he do it? Glory be to God. He moved the excuse from, God help me to close. He moved the excuse from Adam. Glory be to God. You start making excuses, all the folk that are making excuses with you are going to suffer. Because somebody stand up and say, that's wrong.
Amen.
Glory be to God. I know it look impossible, but we're called to deal with one that make impossible things possible.
Yes,
Adam said, that woman you gave me.
Yes.
All right. Since you're making excuses, I'll put you where she won't bother you. Out in the field, working by sweat of your brow, and she ain't gonna listen to Satan because she's gonna be too busy having pain. Glory be to God. I'm serious, y'all. Amen. And so Moses said, God, I stutter. I can't talk plain. I'm going before a king and king's servants that know the law, and they got it down to the letter. So in the midst of me stuttering, I might not be able to tell them exactly what you said. God said, come here, Aaron. Glory be to God. God don't choose folks way over yonder to assist me. He choose you right among them.
Amen.
Right, so, of course, Neil, what you do? And he said, Moses, be Aaron's spokesperson. Amen. Just because you're a good spokesperson don't mean you're going to be a leader.
That's right.
Amen. I know that one caught you off guard. But Moses said, Josh, Aaron, God wants you to be my spokesperson. Aaron went on down as spokesperson. I hadn't read too much what Aaron spoke at Pharaoh's greeting to tell him to let God people go. But when he should have spoke up, when Moses was up in the mountain, hearing from God, people building golden calves, he should have said, no! I don't stand with you to be a golden calf. Moses is coming back. His sister saying, let the people do what they want to do. Amen. Moses been gone a long time. Maybe it's our time to lead. You better be surprised. Amen. God know I plotted. Amen. I'm talking to all of you. Say amen. And I'm talking to those that I don't know because you're going to tell them. You're going to tell somebody that I ain't talking to. That better not act like that. God see everything. Glory. God see you on your job, in your cubit, in your desk. Some of you been promoted. Glory. And can't get along with nobody. Glory. Exercising your authority. You better treat people right. The world will set you up and calling you to be hungry in the unemployment line. Glory be to God. Don't think of you got that nice job and got a promotion that God ain't aware of. He putting you in that position so you can show people how to be humble. He blessing your business. Glory be to God. Keeping the income coming in. You don't have to lie and cheat and steal. As God people. Glory be to God. Don't create no business with this stimulus money. Glory. You ain't got no janitorial service. You ain't no mechanic. Hallelujah. You ain't no housekeeper. You ain't got no maids to pay. The devil is a liar. I know you don't like this, and it's not popular gospel. My God, hallelujah. But somebody need to hear me. Glory be to God, hallelujah. And so he said, and Moses come down from hearing from the Lord over God's people. Glory be to God. I have to be careful. You have to be careful, preachers.
Amen.
Don't let people exalt you and call you to smite the rock.
Yeah.
God told you to touch it, you touch it.
Amen.
Don't let people get you angry and pull you out of your holiness.
Amen.
Don't let people get you exalted with causing you to do wrong to God's people. And God told Moses coming down, that messed up. And he said, wait a minute, I'm going to keep my promise, man. I never told you you was going into Canaan. I told you you would lead the peoples out of Egypt. Oh, God. Some of you are expecting something that God, they told you he going to give you.
Amen.
Glory be to God. He said, I want you to lead the peoples out of Egypt. Now, he might have went if he hadn't got exalted and disobeyed God. And God said, come here. Look at that. Showed him the promised land. Oh, my God. Don't let God show you heaven through the scripture and through a revealed dream and you mess it up. You better do all you can do to get to heaven.
Yeah.
I'm going to close out a minute with the song I sung last week. I'm on my way to heaven.
Amen.
My God. And what I say about that song? I'm so glad. But then that's another little song. On my way to heaven. And the journey ought to be getting sweeter every day. We're getting close to saints. And so Moses said, God showed it to him. My God. That's what I should have kept myself and could have gone over and enjoyed it. But I'm going to let you look at it. You ain't going to hell. You ain't going to be lost. But you just ain't going to Canaan. Some of you ain't going to be lost. But there's some Canaan you just ain't going to get to. You done wasted too many wasted years. My God, hallelujah. You just might as well look at the Canaan you can't get to. The things you can't do no more. You just decide, I'm going to live holy to the coming of the Lord. I'm going to clap my hand to the coming of the Lord. That I can do, I'm going to do it as unto the Lord. Because I can't go back and do what I should have did 20 years ago. And so I done left you in so many different places until I can't come back and get you today. But he said, I want you to choose Joshua. Moses didn't just choose Joshua to be a leader of God's people. God chose Joshua. Glory be to God. I don't know who you think is going to be the next leader, but it won't be here unless God chooses. Glory. Brother, I didn't know when I was drinking alcohol, when I was running the street, when I married my sweetheart out of junior high school. I didn't know, glory be to God, when I was partying. Now, she tells the story, waiting on me 5 years, but up until 5 years, she was dancing with me. So much get saved, we forgot what we used to do. And that's a good thing. But then we baby, we used to party together. And she used to love to dance. My God. She still do, she just changed partner. She was dancing and almost got me killed one. Could have got killed one night at a party. Amen. And I saw this harasser. I knew him because I used to party with him. And I knew he was going to be a troublemaker. I seen him terrorize women at a party. And I had my girlfriend with me that night. Saw him coming in the door, staggering, talking loud. And I said, baby, let's go. She said, I ain't ready. Some of you ought to be ready to go higher. Because folks won't go up with you. You saying, you staying back. She said, I ain't ready. And I said, you come. I said, let's dance. She said, and I was hoping that song would never stop. And it stopped, and I said, let's dance again. And the clothes I said that, the clothes he got to was, come on over there. Hey, girl. And I brother, I didn't have nothing in my pocket. Not even a hole in my pocket. But back then, young men and men carried a knife. And I told him, I pulled a bluff. But you can't bluff the devil now. I pulled a bluff. I said, not tonight. Nope. Ain't no
dancing tonight.
I didn't have nothing. I couldn't even run. You'd have called me a coward. I couldn't even tell it till years after I got married.
Not tonight. Look, a girlfriend, before you get married, before you sleep with them, they like to see it. They like to see their boyfriend, who they intended to be engaged with, have some bravery.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. Show yourself. Glory be to God. Don't push your girlfriend or your wife out front to fight for you. She ain't no warrior. She's your wife.
Amen.
Say amen. And anyway, I said, not tonight. No dancing tonight. And what some of y'all tell the devil, not tonight.
Glory.
Put your hand in the word of the Lord. Not tonight. Not today. Not forever. I'm not running anymore. Hallelujah. I put on such a good bluff till he said, oh, you know I'm just playing. I said, you better be. I can stay a little longer then, because he done left me alone. Some of you need to tell the devil, in the name of Jesus, I'm not running anymore. In the name of Jesus, in spite of my cancer, I'm not running. In spite of depression, I'm not running.
Glory
be to God. Exodus 15 and 26 says, he's Jehovah Rapha.
Yes.
Glory be to God. He's the Lord that heals thee.
Yes.
And if I don't stop, I won't be able to bring this message next time in a timely manner. God is good. He knew exactly what he done.
Amen.
He's able. Got ready to use Abraham. Holler out, Abraham!
Amen.
Where are you? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You know where you're at? Same God told Abraham, where are thou? It's the same God. When we mess up, you want to know where we're at? Told Adam, Adam! Y'all ain't gonna let me preach good. Glory be to God. Where are God? When we mess up, God got to hunt for us. He got to require for us. He got to call for us. But when we're in good standing, he meet with us where we're supposed to be. You ain't where you're supposed to be in the Lord. He's calling your name. Where are you? Glory be to God. Where are you? We had a good relationship. Obey me. Where are you? When I was blessing you, told you to leave your kingdom. And I'll make you father of many nations. I'll give you children that you can't count. Assemble at the stars. Glory be to God. God love us. Said it in a song. Don't sing it. You don't have to. Just simply say it to those that didn't believe in it. Probably messed up or felt lonely or been forsaken so much. He said it in the scripture. What can you do? No nakedness. Nothing would be able separate you, me, from the love of God. And we can stop loving God, but we can't do nothing to stop him from loving us. Isn't that good preaching that no matter what we do, what we have done, God still loves us? And the only reason he loves us, if he don't love us, his name won't be any good. He would be a liar like Satan if he didn't love us in spite of. Because he said in his word, God is.
Yeah.
That's his name, love. Glory be to God. He will not mess up his name. Maybe you hadn't heard this before, but this is good preaching.
Don't mess up your good name in holiness. Do your best not to repent. Hear the voice of this preacher that backslid and came back and telling us, hear the voice. It's not so easy to come back. Everybody don't make it back. I didn't say everybody was lost, but everybody backslide, repent on their way back. Glory be to God. While we got opportunity, let's enjoy Jesus. Let's just live right. Let's just do right. I just preach the Bible today. I'll do better next time. I just preach Jesus. To his people, right here, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. It appears that the mother and I planned this. Amen. But God planned it. How can I go contrary to she lifting Jesus in the Sunday school, and I come up here and preach the world? Don't get caught up. Amen. Don't get caught up because we are few. Don't get caught up because we're just having one service right now on Sunday morning. Don't get caught up because we're still having conference call on Wednesday night. Don't fail. Don't fail to assemble. You dial in, glory be to God. And don't get caught up in trying to compare me with these educated religious pastors and bishops. Say amen. Glory be. Don't dress me up in bishop uniform. I'm not condemning. Lord knows I wouldn't speak nasty of those that represent in their organization. But we're not an organization. We're an organism. Glory be to God. Don't do me like David's brothers tried to do him. He done come to bring them a lunch and saw them sitting there. What's wrong with y'all? You're in the army. You're supposed to be warriors. That's what I'm saying. What's wrong with us? We're supposed to be warriors. The choir's supposed to be a warrior. The musicians are warriors. The preachers are warriors. That Philistine, the giant, glory be to God. And he said, what's the problem? Giant. And he said, is that all the problem? I'll take care of that. I can handle him. He said, wait, I believe, but put this on. Put that on. Good hearted mood on that stuff. Because he's just a boy now. Probably 14, 15 years old. I'm not theology, but I'm just doing what the Bible said. We said the Hebrew boys went in the fire first, not the Hebrew men. Are you with me? These was followers of Jesus at 30 years old that he said, drop your net. So you had to be 30 years old to at least be called a rabbi. Glory be to God. And no rabbi had followers older than him. Some of y'all trying to be older than me. Glory be to God. Just stay in your age limit. Glory be to God. And you can either call Google and you can look it up in the scripture, but I know I'm talking. I wasn't coming for you with impressing words. I wasn't coming for you with things that I say the little bit I know that God didn't give it to me or it wasn't revealed in the scripture. So he said, well, can't handle all that stuff y'all older guys handle. Y'all been trained for war. You know, you military people, you know how you go basic training. They teach you how to duck, go on a barbed wire in mud. Brittany was going through basic training, bless her little heart. She went through basic training for the military, and we're trying to promote her to go through basic training for the Lord. Glory be to God. You ain't gonna be able to fight no war if you don't go through basic training. Some of you think you can go to war and ain't even been through basic training. But Morgan's trying to carry y'all through basic training this morning. All right. And so he said, I can't handle this stuff. Y'all built for it. So let me use
daddy's land. Y'all ought to be upset to see the devil trying to entrap one of your sister brothers. Trying to overthrow your sister and brother's children. You ought to be upset. Glory, instead of standing back, I know it was going to happen. So shame on you. Glory be to God. He said, you weren't there when that bear grabbed hold of one of my daddy's little lambs. And I slew him. He scared of no bear. No, were you there when that lion grabbed one of my daddy's little lamb and took up, and I ran the lamb, overtook the lion, and caught him by his beard, made him open his mouth and loose. Don't try to kill people till you get the lamb out their mouth. Don't go trying to rebuke people got a hold to your son or your daughter. Just treat them with love and kindness. Get a hold to them with love until they turn them loose. And then whatever you and the Lord do, that's your business. And so he said, you weren't there. When I caught that, I run that line. And I'm running a little overtime. And slew him. And you think I am afraid of that uncircumcised Philistine? I'm not going up against him in me. You know, some of y'all need to stop trying to, look, as long as you try to fight the devil, you're going to lose. We was not saved to fight the devil. We were saved to fight the good fight of faith. Keep your faith in God. You're going to lose every time trying to fight the devil. Don't get caught up in yourself talking about Satan. You can't rebuke Satan. He's already been rebuked. He's already lost. How can you fight somebody that already lost? And he said, I don't go up against this uncircumcised Philistine with sword and with shield. I go up against him in the name of the Lord. He said, in fact, buddy, give me 5 smooth stones right there. Do something. Give me 5 smooth stones. And they probably said, why you need 5? He said, because when I get the head of this uncircumcised Philistine, I want to send a message to the 4 brothers.
All right.
Glory, hallelujah. He got 4 brothers. We're talking about giants, 9, 10, 12 feet tall. He slung that thing up. In the name of the Lord.
Amen.
May God take care of you on the job, Mr. Lord. Drive careful, stay alert. And he loosed the enemy, the giant was fully covered. And the Bible say that it hit him right in the forehead. And he fell dead. My God. And he took his sword, the giant's sword, cut his head off. Went back to the camp, showing them what the Lord has done. Some of you need to cut some things off you. Let people see it was God that delivered me. I should have committed suicide. But it was God that delivered me. I should have died. But it was God that delivered me. So we thank God for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, if there's anybody here today that need to stand before you, ask for your saving grace. You said if anyone come to you, even in no wise, turn them away. May they believe in you for salvation. No other salvation other than in the name of Jesus. May we who need to repent, may we ask you to forgive us, God. Some sin are just between me and you. So, God, we ask for forgiveness that I may be able to rise up and be a giant slayer in the name of Jesus. May you take us higher. May you bless us to be one. Bless every marriage. Bless your people. You're calling for holiness. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Thank God and amen. Well, sing us happy, and you're dismissed. We'll see you in the next service. We pray that the length of time will be rewarding to you at some blessed moment. God bless you. Love you. Good to see you. Good to have you with us. Amen. Good to have you with us. Amen.